bands in the world. And we've got one of them right here in our KUTX studio today, and it's the Beatle Boys. And you're going to hear all about them. And first, I'd like to introduce Julie Frost, who you have some children in the group, and you also are associated with an organization that we want you to tell us about. So, Julie, have at it.
Hi. First of all, thanks for having us. This is an honor. My son is Hudson. He's the drummer. And I started the Music Moves Mountains Foundation when he was around five-ish. He was diagnosed with a handful of disorders, and music seemed to be his only medicine and healer. And so I wanted to help others get music therapy or music education or music outreach, however they can. And he has been sort of our North Star for whatever programs and services. And the Beatles was always present in his life. And he memorized every song, every lyric by the age of five. And we came across Chris, his guitar player of the Beatle Boys, busking down on South Congress playing Beatles songs a few years ago. And so we knew we had to get these kids together. They were living very parallel lives. Mm-hmm. And so they have actually helped us. They've been playing some of our benefits, and now they're about to play one of our sensory-friendly concerts coming up.
And that's coming up this weekend or next weekend?
Next Sunday, June 30th. Mm-hmm. It will be from 2 to 4. We'll have Akeen Francis opening up, playing instrumental guitar, and then the two boys will be playing just a more kind of acoustic stripped down version. It'll be at the Austin History Center.
Okay, well, let's have some music this morning. Sounds pretty darn good to me, and this band is featuring Chris Sebrion. You're the lead singer, Chris. Come to the microphone and tell me how old you are. And
I'm 14 years old.
14 years old. You already play the guitar like a crow, and you can sing really well. You're really doing a great job. And
thank
on
you.
The drums back there, without a microphone, so we can't talk to him, is the drummer that is called. He's 13 years old, and his name is Hudson Tartak. And he's really good. So, Hudson, keep it up over there. We're going to put you to work again. And we've also got Jason Crisp on the bass and Sid Sanchez on the guitar this morning. And all these folks are going to be participating in a concert this, not this weekend, but next weekend on June 30th, a Sunday afternoon from 2 to 4 at the Austin History Center. And Julie, where is the Austin History Center right now? Is it moved or where?
No, it's still in the original building. It's beautiful. It's on Guadalupe and the corner of between 8th and 9th Street.
Right, close to the old courthouse.
Yes, it's directly across from it. It's a beautiful space. It's got high ceilings and just
nice acoustics.
Space. Great acoustics. Yeah.
Okay, so be there for fun, and bring the kids and anybody you want. And let's see. Tell me another little bitty thing about this organization, the Music Moves Mountains organization, and how people might get in touch and plug their kids into it if they're interested.
Right. I mean, we serve children, adults, seniors. Music can help anyone, whether, you know, we do have certain programs that focus on certain areas. We have one called All Abilities Rock, which helps just get better access to music, live music especially, for people with special needs or physical disabilities or what have you. And that was kind of the purpose of this series. We partnered with the Austin Library this year to present these and just make it free, you know, easy to get to. You know, that was one thing that really drove this was, you know, Hudson wanted to see live music at an early age, and that's how we came across Chris, because he wanted to go see buskers on the street all the time,
right,
you know.
Right.
So, but we do everything from help people with financial aid if they need to hire a music therapist. We help schools or individuals with, you know, whatever costs it takes to get people playing and learning and mentorship. We have a program called Play It Forward. We keep it forward. And another thing I love about these kids is that they're learning how to give back to the community as well.
It's so great. So let's have another song, guys.
Back up in the woods beyond the evergreens, through the long cabin made a world of good. A little grudging more.
fabulous, and it's a wonderful performance of the Chuck Berry song Johnny Be Good, done by a young band, the Beatle Boys, and they're performing on the 30th. We'll hear more from them in just a moment, but since that song was going on, it sounded so much like another song, and it's the birthday of one of the guys in this band. Brian Wilson is 77 today. How did that happen? He was one of the Beach Boys, and they've got lots of zillions of good songs. And how about this one? Because it sounds almost exactly like what we just heard.
Do you want to dance and hold my hand? Tell me, baby, I'm your loving man. Oh, baby, do you want to dance? Do you want to dance? Come in the moonlight. Hold me, baby, all through the night. Oh, baby, do you want to dance? Oh, do you want to dance? Oh,
Stellar. In our KUTX Studio 1A today, we have a live band. And does the band go by a name? I think they are called the Beatle Boys. Is that correct?
Yeah.
And the Beatle Boys will be appearing at a performance at the Austin History Center on Sunday the 30th from 2 to 4 in the afternoon, playing all these kind of good songs. That last one was a Chuck Berry piece called Johnny Be Good. And it's right from the beginning, guitar riff that Chris played. It just was a pretty dead gum authentic cover of that song. I loved it. And we've got Hudson Tetrick, who's the drummer, and he's 13 years old, and he's really good. And we also have Sid Sanchez on the guitar and Jason Crisp on the bass. And, you know, as you were talking, Julie Frost, about the Music Moves Mountains organization, I was just musing on the fact that there is so, that music is not only an avenue through which some people can find connection and healing and all those things. It is a world, as we all have music in our heads that we've been hearing since the time we were babies and lullabies. And the catalog is enormous, what human beings collect and identify with and communicate with. And it's the essential thing is communicating, because right. as Hudson and Chris are doing, they are not only being pulled into the river of music, they're pouring it right back out in right. ways that we can experience.
And they became, morning. You know, bringing two kids that didn't know each other, pretty shy, all we had to do is put them in a room together and they started playing before they really had a conversation. And mm-hmm. that was their conversation.
Right,
music
right,
is
right.
their language. So.
Right. That's yeah. just wonderful. Let's have one more song, kiddos. The last song you're going to do is a Beatles song, and it's called Babies in Black. I don't think that's a very popular Beatles song.
It's one of their old school ones.
Uh-huh. So let's hear it. Live in our KUTX Studio 1A today, the Beatle Boys. It's a band that does Beatles covers and a lot of other things too. And you can hear them live at the Austin History Center on Sunday, the 30th of June. And I'd like to say again that the band consists of two adults, and Sid Sanchez is on guitar and Jason Crisp is on the bass, but two kids, Chris Cibrian is their lead guitarist and lead singer, and the drummer is Hudson Tartag. And so that's, you know, it's just really great to hear these guys, because it's just really, really good. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, and they both play naturally, you know.
Right.
And they've got Sid. Sid is Chris's guitar teacher at Austin School of Music, and mm-hmm. he's been more of a mentor and a father figure to these kids as
Great. I have to say, on the way, I was wandering around in front of the building this morning, and kind of taking my slow time, and I decided to just stop and turn around and look, and oh, there's this guy right behind me, scared me to death.
It was meant to be.
It was meant to be. It was our encounter. And so it's, and I enjoyed the music thoroughly. And thank you, Sid, for all you do. And thank you, Julie Frost, for coming in and talking to us about musicmovesmountains.org.
Thank you, John.
Okay.
Really appreciate you.
And thanks to our engineer, Cliff Hargrove. And I'm John Aielli, your host on Eklektikos. And congratulations to all the kids out there making music. Bring some to this concert. I'm sure you're going to enjoy it. Bye-bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I did. And it's about 8 minutes before 8 o'clock. And today is the last day of spring. Summer starts tomorrow.